India. The word is awe-inspiring. Something beautiful, like a dream. India has many colors. It is a country that stands in the doorway of time and is poised to herald a new day. Prosperity, safety, peace, these are just words. But I really do believe that we can build India into a force that guarantees these concepts to its citizens. Through the wheels of commerce and on the wings of culture, tomorrow's India will be a model worthy of emulation. Through efficient government and scientific advancement, through prospering economy and considerate diplomacy, India in 2020 will be one of the world's most developed nations. I believe this is not just a possibility, this is inevitable. But in order to know where we are going, we must know where we are coming from. Years ago, we made a transition. In the history of the modern world, that is not a very long time. In these years, we have devoted ourselves, some more than others, to making ourselves generally more comfortable. Patterns of civilization have made us take from the outside world and give in return that which is beneficial to humanity's progress. But there is something that we often find ourselves lacking. Our development as a country has been sure, if steady. Economically, we find ourselves moving towards betterment. In our embrace of democracy, we are thriving. Collectively, we may whine incessantly about the lackadaisical attitude of everybody else who we must share our country with. We may hold the politicians in very poor regard. We may complain about the lack of foresight displayed ever so often by urban planners and about a plethora of such social ills. But it is imperative that we try and examine the underlying causes of these issues. They say you don't really know where you're going until you know where you're coming from. So we set out to discover India, as it is now, as it was, and as it will be in the future. What does the future hold for our country?
Often a question is asked, whether India can compete with the big economies of the world in industry and trade. My answer is that we are already competing well. Take the case of the hardcore manufacturing sectors. In automobile components, our exports have gone up from $375 million a year to $1.5 billion this year, with 18 of the world's largest auto manufacturers outsourcing components from India. Many of them getting components designed in India. We have the marriage of design, information technology, and manufacturing. India has repeatedly proved that it can deliver skills and low-cost, improved infrastructure. We should capitalize on these assets to become a developed nation in 2020. We have to upgrade our skills. Business is one of the most direct ways of making a positive difference in the world around us. Business brings with it new learnings, wealth creation, and the means to fulfill a society's needs. Who am I? I am the voice of tomorrow's India. I am the voice of the people. I am the voice that demands change for betterment.
down to Gonky Park, listening to the wind of change. August summer night, soldiers passing by, listening to the wind of change. That we could be so close, like brothers. The future's in the air, can feel it everywhere. I'm blowing with the wind of change. What?